Welcome to the 5-minute build campaign, where I want to show you how easy it is to create a token on the Hedera network in under 5 minutes. And the best part, you can use our Hedera JavaScript SDK. Okay, let's get started.
Before we dive into the code, let's understand the concepts of how we interact with the Hedera network. Okay, let's take a look at the workflow to launch your first token. Let's start with defining a .env file. We'll later use this file to define our environment variables and instantiate a new account on the Hedera network. The first variable we need to set is the account ID variable. An account ID acts as an identifier to easily identify your account. Importantly, we also need to define a private key for our account. This key is used to sign transactions. Now we use both variables to create our account. Cool, we are now ready to create our client object. The client object is an important piece in our flow because it allows us to interact with the Hedera network. To instantiate the client object, we have to provide it with an account. This account will be used to sign transactions we want to send to the Hedera network. We call this account the operator account. The client object takes care of talking to the Hedera network and reading its data. Alright, now we have the client object, let's format our first transaction. We can use a token create transaction. Before we can submit our transaction, we actually need to provide it with some details about the token. For example, its name, a token symbol, and the initial supply. Once we have the transaction ready, we can submit it to the network. The client object will actually sign our transaction using the operator account we provided, and then the Hedera network will execute the transaction. As a next step in our flow, we would like to ask the network for confirmation if our token has been created. We can use the getReceipt function. The client object will request the status from the network replies with the status object, and we can inspect it. It was a success to create our token on the Hedera network.
Now we have a good conceptual understanding of the token creation process, let's get started with setting up our own development environment. First, let's open our terminal and create a new directory called My First Token and navigate into this directory. Once you're navigated into this directory, you need to initialize your Node.js project. We can do this using the npm init-y command to create our new package.json file. And further, to interact with the Hedera network, we need to install the Hedera JavaScript SDK. And besides that, we also need the .env file because it will store our environment variables. Installing the package can take a while depending on your machine. And lastly, once your packages have been installed, we need to create a new index.js file which will contain our creation logic. And we also need to create a .env file to store our environment variables in the next step. So now we need to create our testnet account, and we can actually do this using the Hedera portal. The Hedera portal will create an account ID for you, and it will also return you a private key, which you will need to create a client object to communicate with the Hedera network. So let's first navigate to portal.hedera.com/register, where you can create a new account by signing up using your email. Once you have signed up to the Hedera portal, you will actually get a Hedera private key and an account ID. Make sure to copy both of these variables because you will need it in the next step when we initialize our .env file. So let's create our .env file. So navigate to your .env file in your editor of choice, and you need to add first the My Account ID variable and assign it your copied account ID from the Hedera portal. And now let's do the same thing for a private key by pasting in your private key for this variable. Okay, so now we're all ready to dive into the code. Here's our index.js file containing the code to create our first token. First, we must load the environment configuration and import the Hedera SDK. The Hedera SDK contains all the utilities we need to create our token. The environment setup function contains all our token creation logic. First, we need to load the account ID and private key from our .env file. If you can't load those variables, we want to throw an error. Next, once we have the correct variables, let's create a client object. We use the client object to communicate with the Hedera network. Now, set the operator count for the client object using our account ID and private key. The client object allows us to execute transactions on the Hedera testnet. Alright, we are ready to prepare our token create transaction. We use the imported object from the Hedera SDK to format our transaction. First, you need to set a token name. Next, you can pass a token symbol. Each token requires a treasury account ID. This is the account that holds the treasury for your token. It means that the newly minted tokens will be transferred to this account. To keep it simple, we set our own account as a treasury account. Next, we can set an initial supply for the token. let's set it to 5,000 tokens. And finally, we have the possibility to set different keys for our token. We can set an admin key, which has full control over the token. The admin key can actually change the properties of the token. And finally, we need to freeze the transaction so the contents can't change anymore. A transaction must be frozen before signing it using the client object. Next, we can sign a transaction using our private key. And by executing the transaction using our client object, the client object will send the transaction to the Hedera network for execution. Now that we have submitted our transaction, we actually would like to know if the transaction has been successful. By requesting a receipt from the Hedera network, we can inspect the transaction status. Besides that, it also contains the token ID for our newly created token if the transaction was successful. And lastly, we need to call the environment setup function to execute our script. And that's it. Now, let's run the index.js script. If everything goes well, the script will print the token ID to your terminal. Success!
Righty. Just create our token on the Hedera network. What's next? Go to the docs on docs.hedera.com.